We'll see if we can squeeze out a 5 or 8 minute mini intermission. That will be determined by tonight's racing action. Coming up next, 30 lap feet. Outside the 23 of Hitchcock as the 31 of Single gets spun by the 19 of Mays, and he'll collect the 11 of Sawyer, bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. Appears to be that the 31 of Single got spun going into turn number 2. Caution on the Speedway. Row the 23 of Corey Hitchcock, 3 Steve Smith. Second row, 29, Jason Welsham with 1 victory already in his satchel. On the outside, the B00, the Jet, Josh Henry. 30, Ryan King, 71C, Mac McCarter. Diving down on the inside, the 3 of Steve Smith. Is he going to make it home? No, it's still the 23 of Corey Hitchcock, but up on the third spot, the 29 is Jason Welshen. Welshen gets around the 3 of Smith. Now he sets his sights on the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. Jason Welshen already with 1 victory in tonight's 411 Motor Speedway. 2 car lengths behind the 23 of Hitchcock. Then it's the 3 of Steve Smith. Smith flies high just a little bit out of 4. That allows the B00 of Henry to look underneath. But still, your leader, the 23, is Corey Hitchcock. Once again, the 56H of Jordy Horton bringing out a caution. Turn number 2, caution on the Speedway. Drivers are being told to back it down, back it down. On the point once again, 23 Corey Hitchcock, 29 Jason Welshen, 3 Steve Smith. A little high, that would allow the B00 to take a look underneath, but he gets held off by the 3, and on the outside looking in, the 71C of Mac McCarter. Once again, the B00 gets a little loose out of 2, that will allow the 3 to sneak away, open up the door for the 71C, but he'll slide back, once again sliding in third spot as the D00 of Driscoll slides, bringing out a caution out of turn number 4. Caution on the Speedway. Siegel spins in turn 2, bringing out a caution. Caution on the Speedway. Four on the board, 26 to go. Green in the air. It's still Corey Hitchcock. Getting around the B00 is the 29 of Jason Welshen. on the bottom is the 29 of Rusty Valance. You're trying to take a look underneath the 71C of McCarter. They're side by side out of turn number four. Still, your leader, the 23, Corey Hitchcock, with the three car length lead over the 29 of Jason Welshen. To pick off fourth and third spot is the B00 of Josh Henry. A little collection in the back by the 17 of Matt Henderson and the 30 of Ryan King, but they sorted out. Still battling for sixth spot, going down the back straightaway. Now the battle is for the lead. Here comes the 29 of Jason Welshen, sneaking up on the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. It was a four-car length lead just two laps ago. Now they're nose to tail coming out of turn number three. Welshen takes a look on the bottom. It's the young driver, the 23 of Hitchcock, hold him off as the caution on the speedway. Caution on the speedway, the 3 of Smith and the 29 of Ballinger collected over on the back straightaway coming out of turn number 2. Caution on the speedway, 8 of... Discarding the B00 is the 29 of Welshen. Now he'll set his sights on the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. And on the outside, the 63, that's Josh Collins. Third 63, Josh Collins working around the B00 of Josh Henry, picking off third spot. Now he'll set his sights on the 29 of Welshen. As the B00 slide jobs the 63 of Collins, almost causing the caution on the front straightaway, but they'll settle down. They're still side by side going down the back straightaway. Now there's a battle for the lead coming out of turn number 4. The 29 of Welshen takes a look underneath the 23 of Hitchcock. Great battle for third, great battle for the lead. Looks like the 63 of Colin Stomps on the throttle and he'll go high, just giving just enough room to the 00 of Henry. But now the 63 of Collins will pick off third spot. Six car lengths behind the 29 of Welshen in second. Now the 29 of Welshen takes a look underneath the 23 of Hitchcock as a caution on the speedway. Caution on the speedway. 31 of Siegel spun in turn number 2. Take a look on the inside, the 29 of Welshen, but the 23 steams away with a car length lead, diving up out of turn number 4, taking a peek on the inside, the 29 of Jason Welshen. Then it's the 63 of Josh Collins. Once again, diving underneath, coming out of turn 4, that appears to be the quicker spot for the 29 of Welshen. If he can just hang with him going into turn 3, he may have something. We're over halfway. The 23 of Hitchcock, the 29 of Welshen. Battling up to fifth spot is the 29 of Rusty Ballinger, but now he's overtaken by the 17 of Matt Henderson. Fine run, the 63 for Josh Collins. Just a little more horsepower going down the front straightaway. Now he has a six car length lead on the 29 of Jason Welshen. Up to fourth spot now is the 30 of Ryan King, fifth, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Jason Welshen in the 29 carves down another car length, battling down on the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. With the laps remaining, it may come down to lap traffic. That's just the way it is on dirt late model racing on a 3/8 oval here, 411 Motor Speedway, 22 on the board, 8 to go. Fine battle for fourth between the 30 of King and the 29 of Ballinger. The 29 of Welshen not letting up, knowing that just a slight little bubble on the 23 could allow him to sneak around, sneak under, and take over the lead. 26 of Gardner spins up in the front of the 29 of Welshen, but now he'll settle down on the apron and allow the leaders to race for the lead. Once again, pulling away with the four car length lead is the 23 of Corey Hitchcock. Another marker, lap marker vehicle. That's the 56 of Horton. 23 Hitchcock maintains a 5 car length lead this time by 28 on the board with 2 to go. Around the lap traffic, right in the middle of the racetrack, the 23 of Hitchcock taking the white flag. 3/8 mile left for the 23 of Hitchcock and that Eagle racing powered engine. Diving up into turn number 3, getting around the lap traffic, stomping on the throttle in the middle of the racetrack. Put your hands together for tonight's winner, Corey Hitchcock. Fine run, the 29 for Jason Welshen. Coming home third, Superman Josh Collins.
Let's hear for tonight's second winner in the 23, winning from the pole, Corey Hitchcock. Congratulations, Corey. Talk about tonight's event. Listen to all those wonderful fans. Talk about tonight's racing action.
Yeah, it was Welshen and me had a real good race, both races. Yeah, I saw his nose stick out every once in a while, and him and me give each other a hard time and everything. And heck, actually, his girl Emily was telling me she was rooting for me instead of him the first race.
But, hey, Corey, tell us, first off, on those early restarts after the cautions, it appeared to me up in the box that on those early restarts, Jason was getting a little bit better run, especially coming out of 4. Walk us through on how you got a little bit quicker and was able to pull away about 5 or 6 car lengths.
Yeah, we went with a Hoosier instead of an American Racer, and we were just trying something. I think it'd be faster on a more fast racetrack, but it slicked off a little bit tonight, and we just didn't adjust for it enough. But it was more or less just a test session, so... All in all, yeah, he would not jump me, but he would stick his nose out there and every once in a while, and I was just trying to get up top as high as I can, just keep my momentum up as much as I can, because I knew I didn't have a real good race car. So
you didn't have a good race car here in Victory Lane. Now, talk to us about some of your sponsors, and we're going to wish these wonderful fans and your family to get on and come back for a safe night. Talk to us especially about the meal under the engine.
We got a new motor in, thanks to Scotty Evans. He let us try one. We built it for him about a year ago, and we needed to know for our own benefit to sell motors and everything if it made more power and ran and so forth and so on. And turns out, yeah, it's 2 weekends in a row we've been on the pole and second and first. So, yeah, I mean, all in all, a good night. But thank Eagle Racing Engines, my dad, my granddad, mom, girlfriend Katie, KMP Used Cars, Timeless Memories Photography, Total Communication, Hoosier Tire South, American Racer, Jeff Therese, Renegade Race Fuels, just everybody that contributes to the car. I thank y'all.
All righty, once again, another champion right here. Let's hear it one more time for Corey Hitchcock. Congratulations, and congratulations, Robbie Comer over there in the Thunder Lightning. Bring home a big win. God bless each and every one of you race fans. Be careful driving home. Tell a friend, come on back and see us next Saturday night.